How's everybody doing? John and Rock on TV One here. Today, I want to talk about compound angles for whatever reason you may need to do that. Either you're single point threading and you're going to do it with the 29 degree or 30 degree compound single point. So anyways, we're looking at, my lathe came with one of these little, it was a bolt-on plate right here. Hopefully you can see that all right. And it's got the divisions on it for the degree angles. But what you probably can't hardly see, and I can't hardly see it, is the little index mark for where, you know, 0 or 90 would be. I don't know if I'm going to get that all in focus. But there's like this tiny little crooked little line right there at the end of my fingernail. According to, you know, my eyeball, I got it lined up on 29 degrees, you know, splitting the difference, you know, 29 and a half, for you guys who want to do it like that. I'm not sure that all of that actually, once it gets pretty close, if your threading tool was set up to be a 60 degree tool, you guys, if you're watching this, you already understand the deal about the angles. But if you were trying to do it quick, it's kind of hard to see. I personally don't have a need to, you know, do this at hyperspeed. So I just want to show you guys this protractor. Hopefully I can get this in the camera frame here without the wide angle lens on. I'm not quite sure what the range is. Well, I guess there you go. It pulls out 90, and I went by it there a little bit. But it's pretty good. It reads right down to tenths and hundredths of a degree. If you guys can see that. Am I in a frame? Okay, good. So let me throw this on here. Now, we're going to imagine in your mind, in everybody's mind, that the cross slide block on this is going to be, a 90 degree block. And so if I hooch this on here like this, hopefully you guys are seeing it and the camera is okay for you. I put this on here. And hopefully you'll be able to see that or not. If I put it on it, it comes right in. If I squeeze it up tight, fairly good amount of pressure on there to make sure I'm squeezed up tight everywhere. It does come out and say 000, and hopefully I can, I just bunked it a degree and a tenth and a half. It actually does read in at, 0, which would be correct for a 90 degree pot. Let me try to get this in the zoom for you. I don't know if you guys are going to be able to read those numbers like this, but you could take my word for it that it's hitting 00, unless you don't take my word for it and then, watch another video. It does say 00. Hopefully you guys can read that. Okay, so now if we look at my dial, it supposedly says 29 and a half, and I guess I'm not going to be able to do that any closer without throwing manual focus, so I'm not going to. Don't know if you can see this, but there is a tiny little hairline mark there that's crooked. It was obviously an afterthought. Somebody pinged that on there. I'm sure with no, they probably went in the middle of the thing or something. I don't know what they did. So you can't really use that line. And when I get around to it, I will probably mark it myself. But I didn't do any hole drilling on this machine yet, other than fixing a couple of things. So let me just show you a couple of ways that this can be checked this way here. If I was to stick this on a 90 degree part, 90 degrees to the compound, and stick this in here like this, my angle says, it's upside down. This one here is reading in at about 27.25 degrees. Hopefully you guys can read that. Now it says 26.8. But there you go. 26.8 is what it says. I'm sure it was a little bit over 27. So the degrees on here are at least off by a full degree anyways. How much that matters? Probably not that much if you're using a fishtail to set up your threading gauge, which is probably what you should be using anyway, to make your final adjustments in the machine. If you need to be there, work it upside down for you guys. So here's 90 on the thing. Hopefully you guys are seeing zeros there. And then I can butt this end. Butt this end in here and go like this across the front face of that, and again I come up with 28.3 degrees. So we're splitting halves between a half a degree depending on where I measure it at, and I'm sure it's all about my placement why there's any discrepancy. While I can't vouch for the NASA accuracy of this thing, I can say that It does work, and if you guys are looking for another way, you could probably, you know, set up your regular plastic protractor if you wanted and set your nut, you know, and then measure around until you got, you know, a flush feel up against your parts and check your angles that way. I mean, I've even done it with a carpenter's square. So, I mean, this stuff isn't rocket science, you guys. I just wanted to show you another way to set up your thing. Here's another, you know, another reason. If you were setting up your tool post here, and I got my thing, these here Chinese, mini lids come with this here turret tool post. And honestly, I'm not real happy with the way that indexes as far as 90 degrees. And look at it, you can see there's a bit of angles here. So, you know, it's not quite flush. So there you go. There's a reason why you might want to check this stuff. The little divot in here, I can't say that that was, you know, that it's actually 90-90-90 on a circle. So I just don't know. But according to all the other measurements on the machine, I got to imagine that it's only
if you want to get any angles on your machine and you want to do it sort of a fast way, or you want to try and check it semi-accurately,
one of these, it works pretty good, and they're pretty cheap. I think it's definitely under $25. I don't remember. Like I said, it was a birthday present to me, and, you know, I like tools, so when anybody gives them to me, I take them, you know. But hope everybody enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching, and please rate and sub.